oscillation of the ball in the neck of an air chamber. Oscillations of the ball in the neck of an air chamber. So let us consider an air chamber with a long neck. Air chamber with a long neck. Here we have air, and let us suppose that volume of this chamber is V. This neck is very narrow as compared to this total volume. Let us suppose that area of cross section of this neck is, area of cross section of this neck is A. And let us further suppose that a frictionless ball of mass M, a frictionless ball of mass M is held here. This is frictionless ball of mass M, which is held in equilibrium in the neck of air chamber. Okay. Now, pressure inside air chamber is atmospheric pressure, and pressure outside air chamber is also atmospheric pressure. In other words, pressure on both sides of the ball is equal P atmospheric pressure. Means right now system is in equilibrium. Now what we did, we displaced this ball from its equilibrium position by amount y. We displaced this ball from its equilibrium position by amount y. And because of that, there will be increase in pressure in the air chamber, and hence a force will be acting on this ball in outward direction. We will try to calculate that force. As we depressed this ball by amount y from its equilibrium position, therefore decrease in volume of the air chamber will be given by area of cross section into y. Means decrease in volume of air chamber will be given by a into y, where y represent displacement of the ball from its mean position, from its equilibrium position. Displacement of the ball from its equilibrium position. Equilibrium position is also called mean position. Okay. Now, can we recall bulk modulus of elasticity? बल्क मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी हम लोगों ने इलास्टिसिटी वाले चैप्टर में पढ़ा था. बी बी वाज डिफाइंड एज माइनस चेंज इन प्रेशर अपॉन चेंज इन वॉल्यूम इनटू ओरिजिनल वॉल्यूम. डेल्टा पी बेसिकली रिप्रेजेंट एक्सेस ऑफ प्रेशर. अंदर और बाहर की जो प्रेशर का डिफरेंस है, दैट रिप्रेजेंट डेल्टा पी एक्सेस ऑफ pressure. Is it okay? Now from here, if I just rearrange this expression, I may write delta P is equal to minus B into delta V by capital V. Fine. Now from equation number 1, we have change in volume, which is equal to A into Y. Let us substitute that value. Delta P can be calculated as minus B into A into Y. I am just using equation number 1 and substituting value of delta V upon V. Is it okay? This represent excess of pressure. Means, अगर मैं यहाँ पर थोड़ी सी डायग्राम अलग से बनाऊँ, तो कुछ ये सिचुएशन है, ये बॉल, जिसको हमने डिस्प्लेस कर रखा है बाय अमाउंट y, अब अंदर की प्रेशर तरफ जो प्रेशर है, वो एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर से ज़्यादा है, बाहर की तरफ जो प्रेशर है, वो एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर है, अब अंदर की तरफ ज़्यादा प्रेशर होने की वजह से इस बॉल के ऊपर एक अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन में फोर्स लगेगी, ठीक है? And that force can be calculated as pressure difference into area. And that force will be acting towards mean position. And hence, that force will behave like restoring force. Means, अगर मैं यहाँ से restoring force लिखूँ, तो क्या लिखूँगा? Restoring force may be written as delta P into A, where A represents area of cross section of neck. Delta P from this equation may be written as BAY upon V into A. A into A will be A square. It means that restoring force F may be written as minus B A square upon V into Y. Okay, this force is acting on the ball and mass of the ball was taken as M. Here it is M. So may I write this force as mass into acceleration. Therefore, acceleration of the ball due to excess of pressure inside a chamber will be given by minus B A square by M V into Y. Clearly, you can see here that this acceleration is directly proportional to minus of Y. Means, this acceleration A is proportional to minus of Y, which means that this ball will execute SHM, and hence its time period from our standard discussion we have done so many times, t is equal to pi under root of y upon a. We can substitute value of y upon a from this equation number 2, and we will ignore negative sign because negative sign just represent direction of acceleration, that is acceleration is opposite to displacement. Ignoring negative sign and substituting value of y upon a from equation number 2, we will get time period is mv upon ba square. Important point. Point number 1. Agar is ball ke oscillations ko, is ball ke oscillation ko, हम आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस लेके चलते हैं. अगर बॉल की ऑसिलेशन को आइसोथर्मल लिया जाए, यानी कि अगर ये बॉल ऑसिलेट कर रही है और उस दौरान जो एयर चैम्बर है, यहाँ पर जो एयर भरी हुई है, उसका टेम्परेचर चेंज नहीं हो रहा, तब जो बल्क मॉडुलस की वैल्यू है, यानी कि बी की वैल्यू है, वो एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर के इक्वल ही आएगी. ठीक है, यानी कि अगर प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑसिलेशन इज आइसोथर्मल, देन बल्क मॉडुलस विल बी इक्वल टू प्रेशर. सेकंड पॉइंट, अगर हम ये मान के चलते हैं कि जो बॉल की ऑसिलेशन बड़ी स्पीड से हो रही है, उस केस में हीट एक्सचेंज को टाइम ही नहीं मिल रहा. मींस अगर हम ये लेके चलें कि प्रोसेस एडियाबेटिक है, तो उस केस में जो बल्क मॉडुलस की वैल्यू है वो गामा इनटू पी होती है, वे गामा रिप्रेजेंट रेशियो ऑफ टू स्पेसिफिक हीट्स, यानी कि सीपी बाय सीवी. तो आप इन दोनों वैल्यूज को बी की फॉर एडियाबेटिक प्रोसेस और बल्क मॉडुलस बी की वैल्यू फॉर आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस इस इक्वेशन में सब्स्टिट्यूट कर सकते हो. ओके.